Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Labiha Aisha, Junior Resident, Department of Radio Diagnosis in MJ Medical College and Hospital, Navi Mumbai, presenting a paper on role of MRI in evaluation of primary intracranial tumors, along with my co-author Dr. Pratik Patil sir, Associate Professor, and under the guidance of Dr. Ashutosh Chitnis sir. Primary intracranial tumors show diverse group of pathologic types derived from various cells in central nervous system. The incidence is around 4 per 1 lakh population and the diagnosis is often delayed because of delayed initial sign symptoms, vague and non-specific presentation. MRI is a highly sensitive imaging modality which allows accurate detection of lesion location, its extent, mass effect, atrophy and hemorrhage, and a better differentiation between vascular structure and adjacent parenchyma. MRI plays an important role in all phases of patient management, starting from diagnosis, treatment plan, response to treatment, and recurrence. In this study, we reviewed the salient features of different types of intracranial tumors and their appearances on MRI. Our aim is to study the role of MRI as a method of investigation in diagnosis of primary intracranial tumors. And our objectives are to detect, localize, and diagnose primary intracranial tumors based on their characteristic MR appearances, and to assess their patterns, extent, and mass effect. This is a retrospective study done in MGM Hospital, Kamod in Navi Mumbai over a period of 6 months from November 2022 to April 2023. A total of 20 patients were included in the study and the patients' ages range from 9 years to 86 years. All patients were scanned on Toshiba 1.5 Tesla MRI machine. Diagnosis was made based on the typical MR appearances, location, extent, and associated features. This study includes total 20 cases, out of which 6 cases are of meningioma, 3 cases of vestibular schwannoma, 3 cases of pituitary macroadenoma, 1 case of craniopharyngioma, 1 case of ependymoma, 1 case of parasitic astrocytoma, 1 case of glioblastoma, 1 case of glioma, 1 case of hypothalamic hamartoma, 1 case of chordoma, and 1 case of pineal parenchymal tumor. Now starting with case number 1, a case of meningioma in a 68-year-old male patient presented with altered sensorium. The image is showing a well-defined mass lesion appearing hyper-intense on T2 and flare involving the right frontoparietotemporal lobe separated from brain parenchyma by a CSF cleft and causing compression in the form of midline shift and displacement of right lateral ventricle, showing dural clefts and a dural tail sign and effacement of adjacent sulci and gyri. Now moving to case number 2, a case of left-sided vestibular schwannoma in a 38-year-old female presented with headache and giddiness. The image shows well-defined T2 hyperintense lesion arising from left cerebellopontine angle extending into left internal auditory meatus and showing homogeneous post-contrast enhancement. Moving to case number 3, a case of pituitary macroadenoma in a 44-year-old male presented with headache and visual disturbances. The image shows a well-defined mass arising from cella causing its mild expansion and it shows narrowing in the region of diaphragma cellae giving rise to typical figure of 8 appearance and shows supracellular extension causing compression of optic chiasma. Now moving to case number 4. A case of craniopharyngioma in a 25-year-old female patient presented with headache and visual disturbances. A well-defined mass appearing hyper-intense on T2 and on post-contrast enhancement showing a peripheral thin rim of enhancement and causing compression of optic chiasma. Now moving to the next case, a case of ependymoma in a 35-year-old female patient presented with headache and neck pain. The image shows a well-defined mass appearing hyper-intense on T2, showing multiple flare hyper-intense septae within, appearing hypo-intense on T1 and showing Heterogeneous peripheral post contrast enhancement along with enhancing septa within arising from the floor of fourth ventricle causing its dilatation. Now, moving to the next case, a case of pilocytic astrocytoma in a 25-year-old female presented with persistent headache. The image shows a large solid cystic lesion in the right cerebellar hemisphere. The cystic component is appearing hyperintense on T2, hypointense on T1 and showing bright post-contrast enhancement. And it is causing displacement and effacing the fourth ventricle. Now, moving to the next case, a case of glioblastoma in a 53-year-old male presented with chronic headaches and vomiting. A large intraaxial mass arising from splenium of corpus callosum on left side and in left parietal lobe, appearing heterogeneously hyperintense on T2 flare and showing avid peripheral post-contrast enhancement with non-enhancing central areas within, surrounded by diffuse perilesional edema and showing an extracranial extension through a bony defect and causing extreme compression of occipital horn and body of left lateral ventricle. Now, moving to the next case, a case of glioma in a 49-year-old male patient presented with headache and seizures. The image shows a large mass centered on genu of corpus callosum extending into both frontal lobes and showing heterogeneous enhancement with central non-enhancing areas within, suggestive of intralesional hemorrhage and necrosis. Moving to the next case, a case of hypothalamic hamartoma in a 9-year-old male patient presented with seizures. The image shows a well-defined mass arising in the region of hypothalamus on the left side. Moving to the next case, a case of chordoma in a 28-year-old female patient presented with headache and epistaxis. The mass involving nasopharynx, clivus, inferior aspect of pons and the cella dorsica. It is showing few small T2 hyperintensities and vivid post-contrast enhancement. And lastly, a case of pineal parenchymal tumor in a 39-year-old male patient presented with headache and painful eye movements. The image shows heterogeneously hyperintense T2 signal intensity mass arising in the region of pineal gland comprising the tectum. Now the conclusion, MRI is a powerful, non-invasive, rapid and utmost important modality in detecting intracranial tumors. MRI with excellent capture of soft tissue anatomy, better delineation of pathologies, increased contrast discrimination and its ability to obtain images in different planes can better define precise location relative to important neuroanatomical structures. Its extent, mass effect, relationship with ventricles and vascular structures, presence and severity of secondary changes like hemorrhages, herniation, complications, which is extremely important for optimal surgical radiotherapy, planning and evaluation of treatment response and recurrence, and it helps a neurosurgeon to plan for surgery. And the references.